Hey, what's up guys? I'm sure you all know that Windows search bar is a built-in feature that allows you to search for files, apps, settings, or even web content all in one place. It's a fast and convenient way to access what you need without having to open separate programs or browsers. But sometimes it stops working. If you have faced this scenario, then stick around in this video. I will show you five possible solutions to get rid of this problem. My name is Mazhar, and at Rightsolutions, I create tutorial for all you DIY people. Now, without any further ado, let's get to this video. Solution one, restart Windows Phone Cache service. And for that, come here down to the search bar and type here services.msc and now hit enter. Services panel will open. Let's maximize it and click on this name tab to sort it by the name. Now look for this service called Windows Phone Cache service. And it is here, just it's this one. Click on it, and you will see that on the left side on the top, a new menu had opened up, which says stop and restart. So you can just click on the restart. It will stop and restart the service again. So it's restarting, so just wait till it finishes. And now make sure the service is running again. And now we are done with this. So just click on this close panel to close it. So most probably your problem is solved. If this did not work, so head to the solution number two. Solution two is to restart the Windows search. For that, come to the Windows Start button here and right click on it and now select Task Manager. So the Task Manager will open up. Let's maximize this one too. And now on the left side here, just look for the icon with the label of services. So just click on it and it will bring up all the services here. So just click on the name tab again to resort it again. And now here, just look for the service called WSearch, which stands for Windows Search. So here is WSearch, click on it, and this time right click on it. And from here, now you can select stop and restart. So just let's go click on the restart. So it will do the same, stop the service and we'll restart it again. Now make sure again the service is running. Now close this services panel and let's head to the solution number three. And in the solution number three, we will rebuild Windows Search Index. And for that, come to the search bar here and type control panel and hit enter. The control panel will open up. Now in the right side, in the top corner here in the search bar, type here index. In the results, you will see indexing option. So just click on it. A new pop-up will open up and you can see there it says 542 items indexed. So we are going to rebuild them again. So for that, just come down to this advanced button here and click on it. Another pop-up will come up and you will see a few sections here, and in the middle one where it says troubleshooting, delete and rebuild index. Next to it, there's a rebuild button. So just click on it and you will get another warning which will give you all the details. So just click OK. And now pay attention on this top summary area where you had seen all these items before. And now you can see it resetted the number to zero and started to re-index again. It will take a while. I will fast forward it. You can see number of items indexed and it says that indexing is complete. So now you can just close this dialog box and close the control panel as well. And now let's head to the next solution. Solution number four, run the search and indexing troubleshooter. For that, come here to the Windows Start button, right click on it, and this time select terminal with the admin rights. And provide the required permission and the terminal window will open up. And it's a very long command. I had copied this and I'm just pasting it here. You can do the same thing. I'll just put this command line into this description of this video. After pasting or typing, hit enter and you will see the pop-up will come up here, which will tell you troubleshoot and help prevent computer problems. And it has few options here, but we are going to click on next. And on this next page here, you can see that it is asking you what problem do you notice, and then it says select all that applies to you. And there are a few problems had been listed. So you can just select which one and maybe all of them if applies to you. I will select the first one, which says can't start a search or see results, and click on next. And you can see that it says troubleshoot did not identify any problems because I had run already a few solutions. So if there was any problem, it's already been corrected. In your case, could be different. Let's close it and head to the solution number five. Solution 5 is to check for updates. I purposely kept it at the last because most Windows are configured to check for updates automatically. But for some cases, if it has been disabled or for some reason you are not able to reach to the updates, so let's do it manually this time. So come to the Windows Start button here, right click on it and select Settings. In the Settings page here on the left side, look for the Windows Update and click on it. And on this update page here, you can see the first line which says get the latest update as soon as they are available. Make sure this button is on so you don't have to come back and do it manually. So now let's click on check for updates button here. And now you can see it start connecting to the server and checking for the updates here. It will check all the available updates and will list them here. And you can just click on download and install all button. So it will keep on installing all one by one, so it does not have to wait for the scheduled time, which is most of the time 2 or 3 a.m. So that's it for this video, guys. If you think this video given you any help, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you with next video. You have a wonderful day.